What's up, everyone? It's your boy Norin, Radd89 here, bringing you another Radd movie review. And today we're going to be talking about Denis Villeneuve's new film, Dune, a very anticipated film for this year. Is this a masterpiece, an epic film, or does it fall flat? Let's find out. This is going to be a non-spoiler review. Let's get into this. Roll it. So Dune is the new sci-fi epic that was released this year. Oh man, it's been eagerly waited. This was supposed to come out, I think, last year or even before that. It's been delayed a couple times, but finally got a chance to see it. And it's by Denis Villeneuve, who's one of my favorite newest directors in town, like in cinema, because he directed Blade Runner 2049. I adore that film. Like, oh, for real, that's a great film. He's just a really stylish director. So let's get down to talking about this movie. Of course, like I said, this is going to be a non-spoiler review. And first we're going to be getting into my positives and then into my negatives, and then we'll do my rating and then cap it off. So what I really did like about this film is, of course, our director in the helm of the chair and the project. He has such a great style, and you can tell, like, the way he portrays, like, his storytelling, it's definitely perfect for this style film. And it's so masterful told, like, oh, every part of this film. It's got really good cinematography as well. The costume design, all those kind of things do well in assisting the story and making it feel like a very three-dimensional world that feels lived in. Add to that, we got an amazing cast, like, you know, Oscar Isaac, Rebecca Ferguson, Dave Bautista, you know, Jason Momoa, Timothy Chalamet. Like, there's an amazing cast of actors and actresses in this film, and they all feel like they just feel like real characters in this film. And as I said, assist in telling the story and making it feel like a three-dimensional world. And I loved that. Like I said, every character, I don't think there was a single character in this film that I didn't, like, enjoy watching on screen. Also, we have to talk about the music. The score, the music, the soundtrack, everything for this film is perfect. Like, Hans Zimmer really knocked it out of the park. I think this one is easily, like, really close to Blade Runner 2049. That's my favorite film of all time. So I was eager to see this movie. It's got a very good pairing of some of the similar creators. You know, a good new cast, though, to start a different story. But, oh man, the music, like, it's, like, does such a good job too in elevating the story, and I loved it. And there wasn't any scenes that I felt like it was overtaking it. I feel like the music was perfect in every aspect of this film. I think this might be one of the best scored films all year that I've seen. Definitely a very emotional movie too. It's a powerful film. It's emotional, it's political, it's heavy in its themes, and I like the way they tackle those things. All the themes, everything in this film, the way they tackle it. These are heavy subjects in this era, like in this time, you know, for Dune, and it just was really cool to see these actors and actresses portray it. And, like, oh man, like it said, like, all the emotional moments for me, they hit. This was like a slam dunk for me. I think this film really did not, like, the wait, it was definitely worth the wait, because this is a slam dunk masterpiece in my opinion. Now let's get down to talking about the negatives, and there really isn't any negatives, but like, you have to really dig deep and nitpicky status, but we're gonna get down to talking about what I do think is somewhat negatives for this film. One thing I think that's a negative with this movie is you can't be I don't think you can be an average viewer and just go see this film. I think you have to somewhat know the content. You have to have either read the books, seen the old Dune movie or TV show with the Children of Dune, or you would have to know, like, research the subject matter somewhat. I don't think you could go into this film and, like, totally grasp what they're talking about or be as engaged with these characters if you don't know the source material in some fashion. Another thing for me, this is a very nitpicky one. Like I said, you have to really kind of dig deep into this to try to find negatives, because this is an amazing film for sure. But a negative I can say is that it isn't a complete story. This is clearly a part one. When you watch it, it's evidently known it's just a part one. There isn't, like, a clear beginning, middle, and end. It doesn't feel like that. So it feels unfinished. So I know we're getting a part two. It's gotten greenlit already. So that's what I mean. That's the only other thing. Like, I would say similar to, like, Kill Bill. Like, when I watched Kill Bill Volume 1, I have to watch Kill Bill Volume 2. That's how it's probably going to be with Dune. When I watch Dune Part 1, I'm going to be like, well, we're stopping, right? No, we're going to go watch Dune Part 2, right? That's how it's going to be for this kind of film. But overall, I had a freaking amazing time with this film. Dune, in my book, is going to get a 9.5 out of 10. This is a slam dunk. Like I said, almost a near perfect film. For me, the main thing that keeps it away from getting that 10 out of 10 is that it isn't a complete story yet. Once we get Dune Part 2, I'm hoping that it'll just elevate this film to a new level, and they'll be like two of the greatest films, like, you know, best pairings of films that we've had in many decades. So I can't wait to see Dune Part 2. And if you've seen Dune, let me know in the comments section what you thought of this film. Did you have a blast? Was it hard to grab onto the subject matter if you were like not a huge fan of this, or did you have a good time with this film? Let me know in the comments section. I would love to hear from all of you. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss a thing. And have a safe and happy day, everyone. Peace out.